we're back here in Springfield. I had a little bit of narrative, I suppose, about when the trusses for the roof showed up. And, you know, it's important to ideally place them in a position where it's the easiest to put them up. On the truck, the trusses came in four separate bundles. You know, when the trusses are delivered and placed down the roof, I want to lay them flat. Can you boom down and cable up a little bit?
That's as far as I can boom down to do.
Okay.
Shut me off.
Okay. Come about 3 feet, hang over 3 feet here. I wanted to put them on the interior wall so that it, you know, the trusses are not strong when they lay flat. They're not, that's not the way they're intended to live. They're intended to live straight up and down. To store them, I laid them flat. And that means I needed to lay them on the interior walls for support.
There we go.
Any little board. There are three different types of trusses in this building. There's a common truss, a gable truss, and then there are special trusses where that firewall is in the middle of the building. So, common trusses have webs in it. They are intended to bear on the front and the back wall. You can tell which direction these trusses are running because you can look at the tails. You always know that that's going to be a bearing wall and this is going to be a bearing wall. The trusses are intended to push their weight on those bearing walls. all the other walls pretty much would never need to be there to hold the roof up. Okay, those are common trusses. On the end here, we have what's called a gable truss. It's got the bottom cord and the top cord and the tails, just like all the common trusses, but it doesn't have any webs in there. It's bearing on this exterior wall. It doesn't need them. What it does have is vertical webs, if you want to call them that. It's studded in. It replicates the stud layout from the wall below, so that when you put your wall sheeting on and the siding on, you have something to nail it into. So those vertical studs, they're flat. They're not on edge, because we're not concerned about insulation up in the attic or wiring or anything like that. So they're flat, and they're on 16-inch centers. Both ends get those gable trusses, and then all the common trusses. And then in the middle, it's a combination of the two. And then there are special trusses where that firewall is in the middle of the building.
So the firewall is up, and as you can see, a couple inch gap in between each side of the firewall. And that's hopefully to give it some, I guess, airspace if the fire did try to go through both walls.
Firewalls require to have sheetrock on the inside, and it creates a complete separation between the two sides. So if there's a fire on one side, it takes a while to burn to the other side. It turns out that they made trusses that were webbed for strength. They could bear on the outside walls, and they studded it in for stud layout, so we could apply sheetrock to it. We're going to put this one right on top of that, with the gable part down. That's the gable truss. Got that. And then, yeah. And I'll put all the commons up and have to pull that one off. The way this is, someone's got to flip them over. Okay, so there's three different types of trusses on the truck. There's four bundles, and they know how you're going to want to put them on. I mean, they put the gable truss on the bottom, and then probably 10 common trusses. And then the next bundle will have 10 common trusses, and then one of those firewall trusses, the combo trusses on top. And then they'll go backwards all the way up to the top of the step. And my job when the truck shows up is not to make a mistake and put them in the wrong position. It's a bunch of triangles. Triangles are, you know, you can't crush them, they won't change their shape unless one of the components breaks. In a roof truss, you're talking about a bottom cord, a top cord, and then webs that tie it all together. The webs create triangles, they create strength for the truss. And, you know, the truss company that made these engineers, they figure out exactly what type of webs they need in what position, and they build them. I'm not an engineer, and I do not know that, and I don't question it. They do what they do. trying to orient them in the proper direction so I didn't waste any effort putting them up. If you put them in the wrong place, you have to shuffle them and move them, and it's a difficult thing to do, and it's a little dangerous because you're up on top of the walls. So I did my best. Action footage.
Woo!
I wish there was enough room to put a bundle laying flat and leave room to work there. A bundle laying flat and room to work here. There isn't. So we'll have to do the ends of the building first, get them stood up, put as many trusses as we can. You know, we'll come to about here. But then have to stack up the four that we can't set yet against that part of the that's already up. Same thing at the other end. Then drag these gable trusses out, these special ones. And then, I'll look down. Just this section here, there isn't anything to hold them up. The two bundles in the middle, there was just one small little wing wall where the refrigerator goes to bear them on. So I'd set them on the demising wall, and then I had to prop them up with 2x4s vertically that were placed underneath the voids that didn't have any support to help hold them up. Wasn't sure how long they'd be here. I mean, some people stand them up and put a brace on each side and know that they're coming back in a decent amount of time to put them up. So that everything is supported. It's, they're not going to blow away because they're laying flat. And then when it comes time to put them in place, ideally I don't have to shuffle too many of them and around.